Thank you, everyone, for joining us again. I know we were not here for a few days, but we are back. My name is Ashley, and I'm here with VOA Learning English science and technology writer and expert, Bryan Lynn. You want to say hi?
Hello, how are you? Hello, everybody.
Good.
Glad to be here. Thanks for having me this morning.
Of course. Yeah. Thank you for joining us for your first and definitely not last time. Today we are talking about some of the top video calling apps that people around the world are using right now for learning, for the job, and just for keeping in touch with their friends and family. With about a quarter or one fifth of the population right now under some sort of stay-at-home guidelines, these apps are kind of exploding with activity. So, Bryan, could you tell us a little bit more about the story and what you looked into?
Sure. So, in researching the topic, I think I came to two basic conclusions. The one is how much these services have grown in the last, in the past weeks and months, just how many people are using them now, and also how many of them are out there. I mean, there's a lot more than I even knew about. There's a lot of major ones that you know about, but there's a lot of smaller ones, and most of them don't cost money or very little. They're easy to use. You can use it on desktop, on a device, your mobile phone, whatever. So, and also I think that, as you said, because so many people now are looking for some way to stay in touch with family, they're also being required to stay in touch with their work. Some people are using these for the first time. They've never even used maybe anything beyond Facebook. And so I try to take a few of the main ones and kind of give a description of it, the advantages of them over other ones. We took a look at some that people would use typically for work. One of those is Slack. I know a lot of people in the tech industry are using Slack every day in their jobs, even if they're not in an office that's thousands of miles away. They could be in the same office, but they're using it to communicate through chat, screen sharing, that kind of thing. And then on the other end of it, there are the ones used for social, either with family or there's even a group app, which is made for kind of more of a party atmosphere. So it could be hundreds of people virtually and, music and comedy, those kinds of things. And that one's called House Party. So that was interesting too, something I didn't know existed, but it's really grown in the last little while too. So,
Dr. Jill, could you show us the list of the apps that we looked at, or that Bryan looked at? There we go. Sorry, you were saying?
Yeah. So these are the ones, the main ones we looked at, and kind of what we thought would be good to do was get some comments from people who are, our users and people who are out there. Obviously, we're using Zoom today, so we're familiar with that, so are they. But as I said, there are other ones out there, so we kind of wanted to get a conversation going, maybe as to what they've used, what they like. Skype is another one that's very big and it's been around for a long time. For some reason, Zoom has really taken off in the last, and in doing research for the story, I found that there were pretty good reviews with Zoom as far as quality, video quality, overall reliability of the call, making it through the entire time as compared to Skype in that regard. So, but it would be interesting to get people's opinions about what they're using. Obviously, another use would be for educational use, either on a one-to-one basis or in a classroom situation. So maybe people have experience with that as well.
Yeah. So this is our first question. If you guys want to practice speaking or typing, we will get in touch with you. Again, as we said, you can go to the participants box and then raise your hand if you have a response. And so the question is, which of these services do most people you know use? So the slide just before this listed like Zoom, Skype, Duo, which I've never heard of, House Party, Teams, and others. And a lot of people just use like WhatsApp still as well.
Exactly, yeah. So whatever, you know, there might be things on there that are even popular in certain countries that aren't on that list. So would be interesting to find out.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes. Were you going to answer the question?
Yes. Okay, regarding to your question, actually, what are my experience? The most common app we are using now is the Skype. But now this day, I mean, it's during maybe at least during the this month, most of my friends start using Zoom for the communication for the meeting, because compared to Skype, the communication is better compared to Skype. There we support for some feature. We can, for example, you can see you can mute me or unmute me, and then who can say, and we can raise your hand, for example. It's compared to Skype, I think Zoom is become more common than Skype. But earlier, for the personal or for some meeting is only two or three people, Skype is still more useful and easier.
Mm-hmm. So smaller groups, yes. Skype is still, yes, most popular. Okay.
So compared to your question, so my answer is the most common is Skype, and the second for today is Zoom. Mm-hmm. For the team or the duo, I don't hear before until today.
Teams.
Yes.
Teams. Yes.
What I'm understanding here is a Microsoft team, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think it's Skype and Microsoft Teams are.
No, different.
They're different, but I think they're owned by the same.
Owned by the same from Microsoft.
Yes.
But the Skype is, I think, more common, and then Zoom. Yes, is my opinion, but I don't know how about the other.
And have you used Skype for? Also for work or business purposes, or just personally with people you know?
Basically, I'm using Skype since 2004. I mean, it's a long time ago. Mm-hmm. And I used Skype for work, but for personal, right. I mean, it's for social network. Maybe I'm using Facebook Messenger or Viber or WhatsApp. Skype is definitely for work. It's not for other purpose. Yes.
Right. Yeah, that was another thing I learned in doing this story and the research, was that Facebook Messenger also had a huge increase in use during this time as well. And also, as we mentioned, WhatsApp. So typically, I guess that's what it is. You always have your phone. And so if it's someone who's in your contacts, and you're already on Facebook and you have FaceTime or Duo, which is the Android version, you're probably more likely just to pull out your phone and do it that way. But for work, that's what I've heard. Skype is still big, but Zoom just took off. So
thank you. Okay. Oh, thank you very much. Yes.
Give me 1 minute. Here is just my opinion. Why Skype is more popular, because it's not require the phone number. You can see if you install Viber, WhatsApp, the phone number is required over there. But come back to your opinion earlier, is now people is start using Viber or WhatsApp, because now Viber, WhatsApp, they support for the desktop, I mean, it's for computer, not for phone anymore. That's why it's Viber and WhatsApp becomes more common. However, mm-hmm. compared to Skype, my opinion is Skype still better.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
That's my thank opinion. You. Yeah.
Thank you. I believe Kim Groh is next. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
How are you? Where are you calling from?
I'm come from Caribbean.
The Caribbean?
Yes. I live in on the island.
Very cool. Which island?
Saint-Barthélemy.
Oh, okay. One of the French islands. Yeah.
Yes. The name of the island. The island of France.
We just call it St. Bart's because we can't say the name.
Yes. Correct. Correct.
So what were you going to answer our first question? Which of these apps do you most commonly use, or those you know most commonly use?
Here on the island, a lot of people use Zoom and Skype.
And how about yourself personally? What is your preference?
A YouTube.
Okay. Bryan, did you have
any? And do you, for those, so you've used Skype and you've used Zoom, did you also find there's a quality difference from one over the other? Like, is Zoom better with the video and that part of it, or is it about the same for you in your experience?
Zoom recently, just 2 weeks, the teacher on the school, my son, UK. So now we know Zoom just 2 weeks. Before we use Skype and mm-hmm. we use the WhatsApp, but now just 2 weeks, the teacher on the school of my son, because all of school stop now, so mm-hmm. the teacher find the system tick for every children, tick for all of the children on the class on Zoom. So we know Zoom just 2 weeks before we didn't hear about.
Yeah, that seems to be a common experience now with people, is they may not have even heard of Zoom, and all of a sudden you're using it. And whether you will go back to Skype or not after this, I guess that's the big question. But Skype, by the way, too. Go ahead.
Skype good too. I used Skype 10 years ago with the job, with my family. Skype good too.
Yeah, I think that from also in the research I did, Skype has also made some changes, I guess, since Zoom came up, to try to make it more to compete better with the service that Zoom has now. And I don't know if that's working or not, but they're trying, I think, to even do some things that Zoom does. Like, I don't know if any of you have used the virtual background part of Zoom. And if that is available in Skype, I'm not sure.
That's what I have. Anyway, you go to preferences and there's a virtual background option, and you can even upload your own pictures and it automatically turns into like a green screen. It's kind of cool.
That's been kind of a fun thing too that I found out. And you know, a lot of people are using Zoom for work, and so they're home and their company's having a big meeting, and so they're, you know, people are at home, and typically it would be sitting at a desk or, you know, in a kind of other home setting. And some of the people who are having these meetings are kind of a running joke what background they have, you know, if it's
yes.
a nice serene beach scene, or if it's a superhero or a video game character, or whatever. It's kind of like every day they're waiting to see, oh, what's the background today? So it's kind of a fun way to combine, you know, if you're going to use it for work anyway, it's kind of a neat feature to mm-hmm. have.
So I think we will take one more comment. Thank you so much, Kim. Let's see. Dr. Jill said Mohammed. Or sorry, Hussein is next. Is this Hussein? Hi.
Yes. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Good evening. Here is evening. I don't know. In America, I think it's morning.
Yeah, it's 8:15 in the morning exactly.
No. Yeah. Here is 7. 7:15.
Great. So how about yourself with the your use of video calling apps?
I'm using Zoom since this quarantine times. Before that, I used WhatsApp, but during this quarantine times, I'm using Zoom because especially on Sunday service that we have. So since we cannot gathering, so for Sunday service, we usually participate more than 100, more than 70, but it's available if we use it for 100 person also. So we usually use Zoom.
Yeah, that's a common answer we're finding, both in this lesson and what Bryan found as well, I think.
Yeah.
What do you personally like about Zoom as compared to the other things you've used? Is it just the convenience now, or are there other things?
I never used it before since it's a new application. Mm-hmm. Is it new, or it maybe I didn't use it before? So for me, it's good to because. For a big meeting. So for a small meeting, we can use WhatsApp or like Skype. For a big meeting, like more than like 70 or 50 person that we want to have a meeting. So I like this because every people can come together and to share their opinions or the meeting that they have.
Yeah, and with Zoom, it's my understanding that it's up to 100 people. You don't have to buy the premium service, right? You can have up to 100 in the meeting. Is that correct?
I never used for 200, but we yesterday we used for 75%.
Yeah.
So I'm seeing in the chat that some countries like Line is very popular in Thailand. May says people use something called Zalo or Zalo in Vietnam. Have you heard of these, Hussein?
I think about Line. I'm not using Line. So usually here in Indonesia, it's popular to use WhatsApp. So everyone use WhatsApp. Before I used Viber. Before I used Viber, so nowadays majority of the people in Indonesia they use WhatsApp. So okay. since we cannot talk, I think more than 4% on video call. So I think that will be increased at the future or not. But right now, it's very common to use Zoom.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much. So we will, I know there are some more people with their hands raised, but don't worry, we have many more questions and chances to talk. So Mohammed, Adriana, and another Mohammed, we will get to you. But first, here are some key words that you used, Bryan, in the article. And so for the viewers, if you follow the VOA Learning English page, you know that we write using kind of a limited vocabulary. We even have a word book with 1,500 words that we try to limit ourselves to, but especially with changing technology and all of that, we just simply do not have some of these vocabulary words in that word book, because it needs to be updated mostly. But Bryan, let's maybe go through these words. And then for the rest of the questions throughout the lesson, you guys can try to use these words if they're new to you. They are very useful when talking about this topic.
Yeah, it's interesting, the first one on the list there, chat, because chat can mean obviously, so the definition we have there is an informal talk with someone. But chat also historically has kind of a technology meaning because of chat rooms and, you know, chatting back and forth with someone online has been used for many, many years. And I think even in today, people will still refer to that function or that feature in the app as, you know, oh, can we do a separate chat? Can we go and chat in another room? So in that sense, it would just mean a more, well, I guess it could also be
a friendlier way of saying, let's have a discussion, you know?
Right. And away from the main discussion, I guess in this case, it would be, you know, taking it somewhere else. Mm-hmm. But it's also used in other ways. Just if someone is, you can even use it as
a verb,
as a verb or adjective, chatty. If someone's mm-hmm. chatty, they talk a lot. They like to talk. They like to have conversations. So.
And feature, we've used this a few times throughout this lesson, I think, means a typical quality or important part of something. So I believe it was Van was saying he liked the feature of being able to mute participants and unmute them and kind of have a little bit of control over the quality of the meeting or conversation. Do you want to add anything to that? Or
I'm trying to think of another, what would be a synonym of feature? Another...
It's too
tool
early.
In a way.
Tool, yeah. It's like a tool.
So yeah, what other tools are available in Zoom, or what other tools or what other things can you do with that app that would be considered a feature?
Or an option a little bit.
Right. It's a word that we use quite a bit, and I mean I use it a lot in the technology writing because a lot of times I'm writing about a new app or a new device when Apple launches their new phones or when Google has a launch. And it's usually we're talking about the features that it has, and it's sometimes it's hard to use another word besides feature. So I'm using it quite a bit.
For sure. Yeah. There's not, we have both had trouble coming up with a synonym, but tool works.
Exactly.
But feature just has a meaning that is very closely connected to like new technology, I guess.
Right.
And screen.
Yeah, that's
that is what we are all looking at right now and probably spend a lot of time looking at these days.
Right. Reliable is an interesting word that we also use quite a bit. Trusted or believed. And I think in the case of what we're talking about now and in the story that I did, it could also be, you know, it means not just that it's a trusted app or that, you know, we can trust using it, but also that it works well, that it functions like it's supposed to, that we can, when we open Zoom and we use Zoom, that we can be sure that it's going to function. The video is going to come on. It's not going to be interrupted by anything. So that's.
Yeah. So you trust it.
Kind of two separate.
Yeah, so it's reliable in like a security sense, or you hear often like so-and-so is a reliable source of information. But reliable, you can also say, oh, I'm sorry, the Wi-Fi connection here is not very reliable. It just means you don't know, you can't trust whether it is going to work one day or another. So,
right. Yeah. So that's.
I think we've kind of already answered this next question. How? There we go. So our next question for all of our participants is this. How has the current world situation changed your use of video calling apps, I guess we should say.
How are you? I'm fine. And you?
Good, good. And where are you calling from?
I'm from Egypt.
Okay. We haven't had a lot of Egyptian callers yet in this Talk to Us sessions. So how about you? How has the global pandemic changed the way or the amount that you use video calling apps to keep in touch with people?
Here we use WhatsApp a lot of time, but it is the first time for me to use the Zoom.
How does Zoom compare to the video calling apps you most often use?
Yes, Zoom is the quality is in Zoom is very good. Mm-hmm. Compared with the other program.
Okay, that's good to know. Bryan, do you have any follow-up questions or comments?
Do you find it helpful now? I mean, if you know, a lot of people are obviously under stay-at-home orders to stop the spread of this virus. Do you, you know, in what ways has it helped you in your daily life, the way things are right now? I mean, have you been using it for work purposes, or are you using it just to keep in touch with friends or family? Have you used Zoom for work purposes or just for personal use?
Yeah, I will use it in work. And in family, because it will help us to communicate with each other.
Are you working from home at this point? I mean, are you able to go to work back and forth, or are you having to work from your home?
No, now we didn't work because the virus, corona. Mm-hmm. But we will come back to work near each other.
In June, okay. You said?
We would come back to work near.
So, okay. Well, thank you so much for calling, and please join us again on Zoom.
So Ishii had a question about a sentence. Is it okay if I throw that on the whiteboard?
Yes. The sentence is, I usually chatty to friends on Skype. So in this case, you would use the verb form of this word, chat, which is just chat. So chat can be a noun or a verb. And chatty is the adjective form.
I see.
Yes. But you can say, I am usually very chatty with my friends on Skype. And that would mean you talk a lot.
I see. Thank you for correcting.
Yeah. But yes, so chat is a verb, chat is a noun, and chatty is the adjective. Hello. So we have another Mohammed who's waiting to talk as well. But yes. Hello, Ibrahim. Where are you calling from? Ethiopia?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Did you have a comment to make about how the current world situation has changed how you use video calling apps? Or do you want to tell us about which kinds you use?
Yeah, just to say a word about the impact of the coronavirus pandemic and the use of electronic ways of meeting communication channels. Now I feel like, you know, now is the time actually to leverage all social media applications like Zoom, and the Sky, Emo, and BlueJeans, and any other ways of communication platform in order to update, connect together, and in order to share information in these times of lockdown. And I feel like if we are just doing all these things, it's actually there for us to pull through and to continue to share information. Even currently, we're just holding meetings on Skype because it's very difficult for us to meet personally in person. So that it made it easier actually to communicate, to update about words. And all the electronic applications help us to work from home.
Yeah, for sure. Bryan, you can weigh in as well, but I don't know how VOA Learning English would be functioning without all of these video calling apps and all of these ways that we can keep in touch with each other. Even like email is good, but it's like having like Teams or Zoom or a meeting platform where you can see people and actually feel like you are with them helps communication go more smoothly, I think. So,
yeah, I think that's true. I think, go ahead.
It's I'm actually trying to learn about the Zoom. It's not actually, I think it's a new technology. Previously, I used to use Skype, which was not user friendly. But Zoom is a lot easier for us to use it, and we can see like lots of participants online. And as you said previously, you do have like control over the participant. You can mute them. It's really important. Like, just look like you know a virtual. Yeah, so it's more than a virtual meeting. I feel like this is like we are just seeing you personally, right? So this is like a huge opportunity for us to continue the job.
Yes, for sure. And I liked how you used the phrasal verb to pull through. I think that's a useful phrase for our current world situation. I hope that we were all able to pull through. It means kind of not just, I don't know, survive, but like make things work as we have with what we have. So yeah, thank you for your feedback and opinions, and your English is excellent. You have very, very natural ways of speaking. Congratulations.
One thing, an interesting question I think that comes up too with this topic is, how is this going to change things moving forward for, especially in the working world? I mean, once people have kind of been forced to use these tools to work and to be able to function, and the companies have had to make adjustments and employees have had to make adjustments, is there going to be more teleworking going on, do you think, in the future because of what's happened now? Or, you know, I don't know if people maybe want to weigh in on that. It would be an interesting question.
Yeah, if any of you do want to weigh in, as he said.
Oh, there's another one. Yeah, maybe you have to explain that.
To weigh in, to, yeah, Dr. Jill will type this in the chat. To weigh in means to give your opinion on something. Who wants to weigh in on this question, for example? Oh, there's a Dr. Jill's typing too quickly.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, hello. Now we can. Yeah. Well, congratulations, because under quarantine, my routine has shattered. But one of the things that continue my before routine is your VOA Learning English. I can hear it every day while having breakfast.
The podcast or the daily
the podcast,
program?
Yes.
Oh, cool. So, we like to hear that.
Yeah, as I it's something that hasn't stopped because, you know, I am not working now. Mm-hmm. Well, I think, talking about the question, I think that we human beings are routine beings. So we are going to be at work in person after all this happens. when all this ends, we are going to be personal and in person at work, I think.
So you think
and
it
where
will...
Are you?
Listen, I couldn't understand the two questions at the same time. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
No, I was just going to ask where you're from.
I am from Uruguay, South America.
Okay.
Yeah. And the things, I haven't done a video conference before, only with Skype, but only for family meetings. But now we use Zoom and Google Meet.
And this is for professional, for job purposes?
No, I can't work because I am a lawyer and I do family law and the courts are closed. Family courts are closed.
Okay.
I mean, they are open, but only for very, 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 how can I say, urgent things.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're glad to hear that you found the podcast there. And also, I don't know if you've looked at the website, but most, you know, all of those stories are on the website, but also much more is on our website.
I know.
A lot of other videos. And yeah, you found it.
I know that I visit the website too, because sometimes we have a 4 or 5 students group that when we could before, we meet and we, I go with a loudspeaker and we listen to one of your articles. And after I ask questions, we answer that. And we have fun.
Great.
And we learn.
Have you been doing these groups on a video calling app yet?
Or some No. Because we are not, I think we are not used to do that video conferences before. So now we interrupt until we can go in person to the library to do that again.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for calling us again. Do you think, I have a question, if this continues for many months, would your work be able to become remote over a video calling app?
I don't think so, because they have to do an infrastructure different than we have now, because for instance, for handing out lawsuits, you have to do in written, in paper. So you can present work in remote files.
Yeah, that changes security. And
I mean, you need to make electronic signature or whatever. You understand that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, can I be understood in that?
Yeah, we understand.
No, because it's difficult, because I have never talked in English about that theme, so it's kind of difficult.
The vocabulary specific.
Yeah,
that's
a problem.
Yeah. Electronic signature and all of that. Yeah. Yeah. Well, thank you so much again. And
now congratulations for the programs and for, I know my English have improved because of your work. So congratulations.
Well, you're doing great. Thank you. Congratulations to yourself.
Good talking to you, Adriana.
Good talking to you. Yeah.
Let's see. We have
one more question if we want to get to that before our time is up. Okay. And it's a good one, Bryan. Do you want to? Oh, no. Yeah, this one.
Yeah. So in what ways have you used video calling to improve your language skills? I think there are a lot of opportunities out there for that, but maybe people can share that. I think as I said, what I think would be a good idea is to have language groups where they could meet over something like Zoom or Skype and on a regular basis just get that practice with conversing with someone and, you know, ideally.
Come on, stop it.
Who's doing that?
Somebody didn't like that question.
You presented that.
But maybe, Dr. Jill, do you know of anything like that? Are there language groups that, you know, that meet on Zoom just for the purpose of practicing and conversing with native speakers?
Well,
yes. There's a group called the Mixer that's based at Dickinson University in New Jersey, and they have organized Skype exchanges for language learners for many years.
Elizabeth, did you get a chance to see the latest question? How have you used video calling apps to practice your language skills?
If I talk about calling apps, I don't use too much because calling is like I am calling to people, not really learning English. Except this. This is calling. I use an app to learning English. This is the only app that I use to learn English.
Yeah, well, we are glad you join us most days. And I think it's a good use of everyone's time right now to meet up in a larger group. We used to do TALK2US on Skype. We used to do that for many years, I think before I even started working at Learning English. So, but that was just one-on-one. And I think it's, you know, it's a trade-off, Dr. Jill, if you want to type that in. It's a trade-off because one-on-one, you can have more intensive practice with a teacher or just a native speaker. But when we have like on Zoom, we can reach more people. And even if you don't speak for as many minutes, you can still hear others practice and learn from them and learn from us, hopefully, at the same time.
What do we define trade-off?
Look it up.
Exchange, maybe exchange one thing for another.
Yeah, so they're, So the trade-off.
Then maybe a benefit of one thing
over another. Yeah, so what I was trying to say is that one-on-one Skype conversations in 1 hour's time, we could maybe talk to 5 people and reach 5 people. So the trade-off of using Skype is that we can't meet all of you, 66, 68 people. And but the trade-off to using Zoom is that we unfortunately can't talk to all 67 of you. So,
and that reminds me of the time we have to sign off. It's so fun talking to everyone. So there was a couple of questions in the chat. One was, what's the next appointment? And it'll be tomorrow, the same time, Monday through Friday.
And we're here. Yes, and Dr. Jill, you will be on with, Ana Mateo.
Ana Mateo tomorrow, yeah.
And if she's busy, I'll probably me. But hopefully it's Ana Mateo.
And we had another question. Which way do you learn a new word? Can you help me? Maybe we should talk about that later this week. How to learn new words.
Ways to learn new words. Yeah, it depends on the kind of learner that you are. But we could get into that.
And Furkan Neo said, please make a group of learners where the pupils can practice. You're free to do that. You can, as you're texting each other, if you want to set up your own Zoom calls, you can do that. But we're limited to just doing it this time because we have a lot of other work to do.
This is my favorite part of our new schedule. So
yeah, it is fun.
Yeah. Well, so I think we should sign off now, but Bryan, thank you for taking part in your first talk to us.
You're welcome. It was great. And I'll be back soon.
Yeah, we'll have you back next week for sure. And and thank you everyone who joined us again, and we look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.